Which brings me to the third lesson, integral to the St. Louis, as it is to that of which I just spoke, and that is Iran, namely the danger of indifference and inaction in the face of incitement, let alone the atrocities that follow. This is, as I mentioned, the 15th anniversary of the Rwandan genocide, where close to 1 million Rwandans, mostly ethnic Tutsis, some moderate Hutus, were killed in less than 100 days. But why this genocide is so unspeakable is because this genocide was preventable. Nobody can say that we did not know. We knew, but we did not act. Nobody can say with respect to Darfur that we do not know. We know, but we are not acting. Nobody can say with respect to Ahmadinejad's Iran that we do not know. We know, and we are not acting. Not one state party, as we meet here today, not one state party to the Genocide Convention has undertaken its responsibility, not the policy option, its responsibility to act so as to combat and prevent this incitement to genocide. And let me tell you, I wouldn't be surprised if the ministers of the day today in the Canadian government are also getting memos from bureaucrats who are telling them, by the way, minister, you cannot take any steps under the Genocide Convention. It's not clear that you have a responsibility to act. It's a policy option. I'm sorry. It's not a policy option. It's a responsibility to act. It's mandated by the Genocide Convention. Genocide Convention has been violated. State parties have a responsibility to act to confront it. And ministers have a responsibility to say to their bureaucrats, I'm sorry, you have given me the wrong interpretation of the Genocide Convention. There is another understanding, indeed imperative, that I must follow. Brings me now to the fourth lesson. La trahison déclare, the betrayal of the elites. It was the elites who betrayed us in the case of the St. Louis, just as it was the elites who betrayed us in Evian. It was the elites who continue to betray us, as in the imprudent acts that took place at the time and since. Indeed, the Holocaust was made possible not only because of the bureaucratization of genocide, as Robert Lifton put it, but because of the complicity of the elites. Physicians, lawyers, judges, engineers, church leaders, architects, engineers, educators, and the like. Let there be no mistake about it. Holocaust crimes were the crimes of the Nuremberg elites at the time. I make no comparison and would not wish to make any comparison between the Canadian elites at the time and the then Nuremberg elites, or between what happened in the Holocaust then and anything that might be occurring today. I'm speaking only about la trahison déclare, the betrayal of the elites, of which it was spoken of in 1938, and which was at the time that Evian took place, and which was at the time that the St. Louis was about to set sail. One only has to read Gerhard Mueller's book on Hitler's justice to see the betrayal of judges and lawyers in the Nazi Holocaust. One only has to read Robert Proctor's work to see the betrayal of physicians who served as gatekeepers to the concentration camps. And yes, one only has to read the great work of Robert Jan van Pelt to understand the minute involvement of engineers and architects in the design of the death camps. As Eloise El put it, that if the Holocaust proved anything, it is that a person can both love poems and kill children. And so it's our responsibility to speak truth to power and to hold power accountable, which leads me to the fifth lesson. And that is, the St. Louis was a case study of the vulnerability of the powerless and the powerlessness of the vulnerable, expressed earlier, in the triage of Nazi racial hygiene, the race laws, the sterilization laws, the euthanasia laws, which targeted those, to use their words, whose lives were not worth living. And it is no less revealing, as Professor Henry Friedlander put it in his book on the origins of genocide, that the first group targeted for genocide were the Jewish disabled. People did not speak up then, and we started to go down that road. in terms of the assaults on the vulnerability of the powerless and the powerless of the vulnerable. And so it's our responsibility as citoyens du monde to give voice to the voiceless as we empower the powerless. The sixth lesson, the danger of impunity. If the 20th century was the age of atrocity, it was the age also of impunity. Few of the perpetrators were brought to justice. And just as there must be no sanctuary for hate and no refuge for incitement, so must there not be any safe haven for les génocidaires. So must there not be any safe haven of those who perpetrate war crimes, crimes against humanity, and genocide. If what occurred with regard to the exclusion of the St. Louis was bad enough, leaving aside whether Blair did or did not use the phrase, none is too many, that was the consequence of the action taken at the time. At the same time, that there was somehow the prudence to be found to admit Nazi war criminals into this country. And so you had the culture of impunity where Nazi war criminals could come in and Jews fleeing the Holocaust were kept out. And if you note a sense of anger in my remarks this morning, you're right. Because one cannot look at what happened then and not be angry about what happened then, even if we are looking about it in the prism of what is occurring today. Because it is this sense of indifference, as Elie Wiesel would put it, which always means coming down on the side of the victimizer, never on the side of the victim. And that brings me the seventh lesson, and that is the danger of Holocaust denial. Because Holocaust denial is not only an assault on Jewish memory and truth and justice, though that would be bad enough. It also seeks to blame the Jews for fabricating the host of the Holocaust. So at one and the same time, it seeks to sanitize the Holocaust at the same time as it seeks to whitewash its perpetrators and blame it on the Jews. Bringing me to the eighth lesson, and that's the important message, and I'm moving to a close, of Zachor, of remembrance. As we remember the St. Louis, it cannot only be remembered as an abstract statistic, just as the Holocaust cannot be looked upon in terms of an abstract statistic of 6 million Jewish men, women, and children, and the others who died.